Oxytocin is a powerful hormone. Hormone oxytocin is secreted by the pituitary gland. It has a number of functions, many of which are associated with labour and delivery and nursing mothers. During labour, oxytocin facilitates rapid and efficient delivery, and after birth, the hormone promotes milk production in nursing mothers. This hormone also appears to be linked with trust, bonding, and love, with people secreting higher levels of the hormone when they're involved in activities with people they are close to. Oxytocin, the so-called love hormone, is being increasingly shown to trigger a wide variety of physical and physiological effects in both men and women. The hormone's influence on our behaviour and physiology originates in the brain, where it's produced by the structure called the hypothalamus, and then transfers to the pituitary gland, which releases into the bloodstream. Like antennas picking up a signal, oxytocin receptors are found on cells throughout the body. Levels of the hormone tend to be higher during both stressful and socially bonding experiences, according to the American Physiological Association. It's like a hormone of attachment, you might say, said Carol Rinkeliv Ellison, a clinical psychologist in private practice in Loomis, California, and former assistant clinical psychiatry professor at the University of California, San Francisco. It creates feelings of calm and closeness. Pregnant women with higher levels of oxytocin during their first trimester bonded more strongly with their babies after they were born, according to a 2007 study in the journal Psychological Science. And compared with other women, women with higher levels throughout their pregnancy and in the first month after birth reported engaging in more behaviours such as singing, feeding and bathing their infants in specific ways that promoted an exclusive relationship between the two, the study found. Comparing urine levels of oxytocin and a related hormone called vasopressin in biological and adoptive children who lived in Russian and Romanian orphanages, researchers found that oxytocin rose in biological children after having contact with their mothers. The study, published in 2005 in the Journal Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences, showed that oxytocin levels remained static in the adoptive children in the same situation, suggesting a psychological basis for why some adoptive children have difficulty forming secure relationships. Research done on prairie voles showed that those separated from their siblings exhibited signs of anxiety, stress, and depression that abated after they were injected with oxytocin. The study, presented at a 2007 meeting of the Society for Neuroscience, indicated the hormone's effects were more evident under stressful situations. A November study in the Journal Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences supported researchers' theory that oxytocin would amplify men's early memories of their mothers. In a group of 31 men, those who inhaled a synthetic version of the hormone found the hormone intensified fond memories of their mothers if their relationships had been positive. Studies showed that those whose ties with their mothers had frayed downgraded their opinions after inhaling oxytocin. In its best understood role, oxytocin is released in large amounts during labour, intensifying the uterine contractions that open the cervix and allow the baby to pass through the birth canal. Physicians have been using synthetic oxytocin, also known by its brand name pitocin, to induce or augment labour since the early 1900s. After birth, the hormone continues to stimulate uterine contractions that discourage hemorrhaging, and more is released when the nipples are stimulated during suckling, promoting the letdown of milk into the nipples. When we hug or kiss a loved one, oxytocin levels drive up. The hormone plays a huge role in pair bonding. Animal research with prairie voles, Vasek et al. In 2000, have found that prairie voles are monogamous. This has been linked to the fact that oxytocin is released into the brain of the female during sexual activity. For the male, it seems that the hormone vasopressin has a similar effect. If secretion of the hormones is blocked during sexual activity, the couple will not exhibit the normal behaviour of being monogamous. This hormone is greatly stimulated during sex, birth, rest feeding, and the list goes on. Researchers have also investigated the role of oxytocin in pair bonding, orgasm, and social behaviour such as trust. The hormone is sometimes called the cuddle hormone because it is related to sexual arousal and bonding in couples. Trust is an important social tool that allows humans to form productive and meaningful relationships at a personal and a professional level. Baumgartner et al. In 2008 did a study within the field of neuroeconomics where they used neuroimaging, fMRI, to study the role of oxytocin in creating trust between participants during a social game called the trust game. This game is used by economists and neuroscientists to study social interaction. In a typical trust game, an investor, player one, must decide whether he or she will keep a sum of money, for example $10, or share it with a trustee, player two. If the sum is shared, the investment is tripled to $30. Player 2, the trustee, now has to decide whether he or she will repay the trust by sharing the gain with player 1 so that each gets $15 or violate the trust by keeping the money. This game is thus built upon the dilemma of either trusting or not trusting. Trusting is profitable, but there is also a risk in trusting. Hormone oxytocin has, among other things, been associated with social bonding and facilitation of social interactions. This has also been seen in trust games, where it has been found that investors who are given a sniff of oxytocin before the game are more likely to trust the other player and engage in risk. Baumgartner et al. In 2008 studied what happens in the brain when trust breaks down. The aim of the study was to investigate the role of oxytocin following breaches of trust. This was an experimental study where the researchers used neuroimaging. First, 49 participants were placed in an fMRI scanner. They received either oxytocin or placebo via a nasal spray. Participants were then told to act as investors in several rounds of a trust game with different trustees. They were also told that they were to engage in a risk game, which is the same as a trust game in terms of financial risk, but it is played against a computer instead of a human partner. The participants received feedback from the experimenters. The procedure was divided into a pre-feedback phase and a post-feedback phase, and the feedback was given in between the two. The feedback given indicated that about 50% of their decisions, in both kinds of games, resulted in poor investment because their trust was broken. Results. The researchers saw that the feedback had different results. Participants who had received a placebo before they started playing were more likely to decrease their rate of trust after they had been briefed that their trust had been broken. Participants who had received oxytocin in the nasal spray continued to invest at similar rates. Apparently, it did not matter to them that their partner had broken their trust. The researchers could also see that different brain areas were active in the two groups. Participants in the oxytocin group showed decreases in responses in the amygdala and caudate nucleus. The amygdala is a structure in the brain involved in emotional processing and fear learning. It has many oxytocin receptors. The caudate nucleus is associated with learning and memory and its role in reward-related responses and learning to trust. The researchers hypothesized that the oxytocin may have a role in decreasing fear reactions via the amygdala that may arise as a consequence of betrayal and our reliance on positive feedback that can influence future decisions via caudate nucleus. It seems that oxytocin may facilitate the expression of trust even after trust has been violated by potentially lowering defense mechanisms associated with social risk. This seems to happen by ignoring the negative feedback, which is important for adapting behavior in the future. An interesting finding was that the researchers could only observe these behavioral and neural results when participants played the trust game, but not when they played the risk game against a computer. According to the researchers, this suggests that oxytocin's effect on trust only comes into play in interactions with real people. Trust is an important adaptive mechanism, which helps humans to find out how to navigate among other humans. Humans need to be with other human beings, as there is a need to belong, but they also need to be careful in terms of trust. Lower levels of oxytocin are certainly adaptive in some situations in order to protect against potential harm, but it is also important to be able to forgive and forget if long-term relationships and mental well-being should be preserved. The results of this study can help understand how mental disorders such as social phobia may develop. It could be due to an excessive fear of betrayal. However, long-term lack of social interaction can result in psychological and physiological disorders. Results like these could indicate that levels of oxytocin play an important role in the consequences of betrayals that we all have to deal with during life, and a further step in research could be to examine how levels of oxytocin influence real-life betrayals.